May your mother have never given birth to you or have wept for you. You're offering me safety when the son of Rasulullah has no safety. Get lost. And they returned back to Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam, Ali al-Akbar and Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas. This shows you the true nature of this man. Then on the day of Ashura, when all the companions, the family members have sacrificed in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas, who was carrying the banner of Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam, comes to him. He says, O brother, ya Abu Abdullah, I am losing my patience. Please give me permission to go and defend you, ya Abu Abdullah. Imam al-Husayn looked at his brother, Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas, who throughout his life never called Imam al-Husayn my brother. He always called him my master, Abu Abdullah. He comes to him and says, my master, give me permission to go defend you. Imam al-Husayn looks at him. He said, ya Abu al-Fadl, you're the one carrying my banner. You're the one protecting my women and children. Ya Abu al-Fadl, if you leave me, then my banner will fall on the plains of Karbala. My children will become prisoners for Bani Umayyah. He said, ya Abu Abdullah, oh my master, but I lost my patience. Please give me this opportunity. He said, if you indeed have to go, then go fetch some water for my thirsty children and women. Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas heard the cries coming from the camp. Al-Ataya. Thirsty, O uncle of Al-Fadl, we have not had water for 3 days in this desert of Karbala. Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas took the bag of water, he headed to the water, the river of Fuat. Umar ibn Sa'd had kept 4,000 men on the river to block the army of Abi Abdullah from reaching the water. As they see Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas attacking like a fierce lion, reminding them of his father Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam and Safin, then they all ran away from him and dispersed and opened the way for him to reach the water. He arrived at the river of Fuat. Look at the true nature of this great man. Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam says, the heart of my uncle al-Abbas was boiling like a charcoal from the thirst. When he arrived to the river, he dipped his hands to drink from the river of Fuat. Then the enemies of Allah say, we saw him doing something strange. This thirsty man never drank the water. He let go of the water. And we were wondering, why is he not drinking, until we heard her with his verses of poetry saying, ya nafsu min ba'd al-husayn kuni fab'athahu la kunti an takuni hada husayn. He said, myself, how can you drink the water when your master Hussein is thirsty? What will you respond to Ali ibn Abi Talib on the day of judgment? By God, this is not the teachings of my religion, nor is it an action of a man of true faith. Look at the integrity of this man. Look at the golden heart of this man. Look at the greatness of this man. He let go of the water. He sacrifices for the water. His loyalty to his master, Abi Abdullah. He doesn't even think of him as a brother. He's a master. He fills the bag of water. And then he starts to head to the camp. He's thinking of Sukaina, Rubaiyah, Ali al-Akhtar, Zainab, Umm Kulthum, the women and the children of Abi Abdullah. And he says, I have to give the water to them. Umar ibn Sa'd cries and shouts, O people, block him, for if he gives the water to Abi Abdullah bin Hussein, then we have no chance of winning against him. So the enemies of Allah gather around him from all sides. He starts fighting like a brave lion, fighting the enemies of Allah, until one of the enemies hides behind the palm tree. As Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas crosses him, he cuts right at Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas. Rahimallahu al-Muladi aywa Abbasa. Aywa Sayyida. He cries, he says, ya.
وقلت حيلتي وشم جبيني.
his head on his chest. He wants to carry him back to the camp. He tells him, brother, don't take me back to the camp. Why, Ya Abbas? Let me take you next to the body of Ali al-Akbar and Qasim and the others. He says, brother Hussein, I don't want Sukaina to see me in the state. The head on his lap, he raises it on the plains of Karbala, wiping it on the surf. A third time he repeats that. Imam al-Hussein says, Ya Abul Fadl, why would not you let me carry your head on my lap? Look at the loyalty to the last second of his life. He says, Ya Aba Abdullah, you have my head on your lap at this moment. Who will have your head? She says, Akhi Abu Abdullah, I see your state has changed. Has anything happened to my brother Abbas? He said to her, Ya Zainab, Abbas is gone. I left him by the river of Furat with no right hand, no left hand, with an arrow in his eye, Ya Zainab. She cried.